Hi, I'm Larry Wygand, President and CEO of Wygand Construction. Welcome to the Lutheran Hospital fifth floor expansion project. Lutheran Hospital has been a client of Wygand Construction for over 15 years. They continually choose Wygand Construction because of our safety culture and our commitment to safety on each and every one of their projects. From our interim life safety programs to our infectious control programs and our overall prioritization on safety for each and every project. We prioritize safety for the simple fact is it's the right thing to do, and we care about each and every one of the employees on this site. So please pay attention to the video, take notes, ask questions, and I wish this project nothing but the best, a very safe and effective project.
Hi, my name is Greg Musi, Corporate Safety Director of Wygand Construction. It's my job to provide you with the tools and information needed to work safely here at the Lutheran Hospital Project. That's why we've created this brief safety orientation video to help cover the do's and don'ts for you and your coworkers. Please feel free to take notes and to ask questions after the video. I'd like to thank you for your time and welcome to Wygand Construction.
Project Safety Rules, Lutheran Hospital fifth floor expansion. Fighting, use of illegal drugs or drinking alcoholic beverages on the job, insubordination to a supervisor, horseplay, or any other conduct detrimental to good work performance and harmony on the job will be cause for disciplinary action and or termination and or removal from the project. Reporting injuries. Report all injuries, no matter how small, to your immediate supervisor at the time they occur. Report all unsafe acts. Report all unsafe conditions. All supervisors reports all injuries and conditions to the Wygand Safety Department. Obeying warning signs. Obey all warning signs and warning flags. Read and understand warning labels and decals on the equipment you use. Never cross a red danger tape without permission. Floor coverings. Every open-sided floor or platform 6 feet or more above adjacent floor or ground level shall be guarded. Floor openings shall be guarded by a standard railing and toe boards or cover. Never leave a floor opening unprotected or uncovered. Always provide a guardrail or cover secured and marked whole. Fall protection requirements. Fall protection is required for any work more than 6 feet above a lower level and not protected by a guardrail system. This rule includes mobile scaffold. Please read your manufacturer requirements when working on a mobile scaffold. Exceptions: scaffolding, 10-foot ladders, 3-point contact. Fall protection requirements. A full body harness and lanyard shall be used when working within 15 feet of a leading edge, the rooftop, within 6 feet of an open pit, on all scaffolding 10 feet and above without a guardrail system, on steel sloping rooftops, when working from a JLG boom lift. Fall protection requirements. All anchorage points must be capable of supporting 5,000 pounds per employee attachment. Equipment training. Only those trained and authorized can operate forklifts, skid steers, cranes, backhoes, personnel lift devices, and powder actuated tools. If you have not been trained and authorized to operate equipment, stay away from it. Be alert of equipment being operated in your area. Equipment speed, job site. Equipment speed, job site. Never exceed 15 miles per hour on the project grounds. Equipment repairs and refueling. Shut off motors when refueling. Never make repairs or adjustments while the machine is running. Personal protective equipment. PPE provided by your employer. Eye protection. All workers shall wear ANSI Z87 approved safety glasses or ANSI Z87 approved side shields. Interior workers will not be allowed to wear dark tinted lenses safety glasses. PPE provided by your employer. Eye and face shields. All workers shall wear eye and or face protection when exposed to flying objects. grinding shields shall be used during all grinding operations. PPE provided by your employer. Protective clothing. Reporting for work. Reporting for work without proper work clothing will not be allowed to work on the project. If you are reporting for work without proper work clothing, you will not be allowed to work on the project. Workers shall wear a shirt with 3-inch sleeves, long pants, and construction-type work boots. No tank tops or cut-off sleeves. During cutting and brazing or welding operations, protective clothing is required to prevent skin damage. PPE provided by your employer. Hearing protection. Workers shall wear approved hearing protection in all high noise level areas as required. PPE provided by your employer. Head protection. Workers, visitors, subcontractors, and suppliers shall wear hard hats at all times. The hard hat policy is strictly enforced. Hard hats must meet the ANSI Z 89.1 safety requirements for head protection. PPE provided by your employer. Foot protection. Employees shall wear suitable work boots in good condition. Boots with hard soles shall be used in the construction areas. Canvas top shoes are not acceptable for use in any construction area. Inspect PPE before each use. Inspect your personal protective equipment before each use. Exchange or replace scratched, damaged, burned, torn, or worn personal protective equipment before using it. Electrical extension cords. Cords shall be suspended when they have potential for damage. Cords shall be placed so they don't cause trips, slips, or falls. All cords shall be designated for hard or extra hard usage. Electrical extension cords. Defective cords and equipment shall be removed from service immediately. GFCI. A ground fault circuit interrupter shall be used on all unprotected electrical outlets. The GFCI shall be connected at the source.